This video clip explains how to mass import property values in ArchiCAD 20. Element properties are fully integrated into the ArchiCAD BIM workflow. One very useful new feature is the ability to mass import element property values from Excel files. This feature works as follows. Create a schedule scheme that includes properties as fields. Generate the schedule. Fields displaying property values normally display their default values unless specifically set by the user otherwise. In many cases, these values are provided by a consultant and the architect needs to enter them individually in ArchiCAD, which can be a long and tedious process. Activate the file, Interoperability, Element Properties, Export Property Values from Schedule menu command. In the upcoming Save dialog, navigate to the folder you wish to save to, then specify the name for the file. In the Select Element Scheme field, you can select which scheme ArchiCAD should export. Properties used as fields in the selected scheme will be exported in the specified Excel file. Finally, click the Save button to save the Excel file. This Excel file can now be forwarded to the consultant, who can fill out data values for these exported element properties. The modified Excel file can then be given back to the architect. After receiving the Excel file containing the intended values for the scheduled properties, activate the file. Interoperability, Element Properties, Import Property Values into Elements menu command. Select the Excel file to import and click the Open button. The Import Property Values dialog opens and displays the contents of the Excel file in a table form. ArchiCAD will automatically recognize if a column belongs to a property. To the left of the title of these columns, there is a checkbox, which controls whether values in the given column are imported into elements. If the checkbox is checked, the values of the corresponding property are imported into elements. By default, all checkboxes are checked. Keep these checkboxes checked, or uncheck them depending on whether you want to import their values into properties or not. The upper left corner of the dialog lets you display values by either listing records by rows or records by columns. Clicking the button lets you switch between these two modes. The table shows info tags and text coloring in the cells to give information about the data to be imported. All cells that contain a value to be imported are displayed with black text. All other cells that do not contain property values are grayed, as these are not relevant in this import process. If a row or column of the table is a duplicate of another row or column, cells belonging to the first instance are displayed in blue, while cells belonging to the duplicate are gray. The row or column title also displays an information icon to indicate this. If a property or element referenced in the table is missing from the project file, text in the cells of corresponding row or column is grayed, and that data will not be imported. The row or column's title also displays a warning sign icon to indicate this. Cells containing no data are displayed as empty, and no data will be imported for those element properties. The Browse button in the lower left corner of the dialog lets you select another Excel file to import. Simply click it, and in the upcoming dialog, select the new Excel file to open, then click the Open button. The Save Report button at the bottom of the dialog lets you save a version of the Excel file that includes the text color formatting options seen in the table. After clicking the button, simply provide a name and location for the Excel file and click the Save button. This report may be sent to the consultant, based on which they can make modifications and corrections in the source Excel file. If you click the Close button, the dialog will be closed without importing element property values. Finally, if you click the Import button, values will be imported for all checked element properties as indicated by the appearing dialog. If we now regenerate the schedule from which the Excel file was saved, we can see that the element properties now display the values we have imported using this new feature.